Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this session, we'll be learning about jQuery effects. jQuery provides several predefined methods to use effects in our web page. Let's see all of them. First is hide and show method. Using hide and show methods, we can hide or show specific elements in the web page. Using toggle method, we can toggle between hide and show. Next is slide up and slide down. If we want to slide up and slide down effects, we can use slide down and slide up methods. You can use slide toggle to toggle between both of these. Next is fade in and fade out. To have a fade in and fade out effect, we can use fade in and fade out methods. Toggle between these two, we can use fade toggle method. All these effects takes two parameters. First one is speed and second one is callback. In speed, we can specify slow or fast or number of seconds. In callback, we can specify the operation that we need to perform after these effects have completed. Let's see all of these things in practical.
Here we have a web page with heading as effects. We have several buttons which contains some text and a class respectively. We have a div which has a height of 250 pixels, width of 500 pixels, background of red color and margin of 25 pixels from the edges. Let's see these in display. So this is how our web page looks. It has a heading of effects. It has several buttons lined up and a div with a background color of red, some height and width. We have included jQuery from code.jquery.com. In our script tag, we have written $.hide.click. So we are giving this button, which contains class as hide, .click method, and on click, we are hiding the div using .hide method. We are doing the same thing for every button. We are using .click method on every button respectively using the classes assigned to them, and we are changing the effects on div. So we'll see these things in action. First is when I click on .hide. So when I click on hide button, the div should be hidden. Let's refresh this once. When I click on hide button, the div disappears. So that's how hide works. When I click on show button, the div should appear again because here we are using .show method. So when I click on show method, the div appears again. Now we are using toggle method on toggle button. So the div should appear and disappear depending upon the previous appearance of div. So this is how toggle works. Now we are using slide up method to see the effect of slide up. Like when I click this button, the div should slide upwards. So here is our div. When I click on slide up, the div should appear to slide up. So when I click on this button, the div appears to slide up. Similarly, we have slide down effect. When I click on this, the div should slide down. So we can see the effect, slide up followed by slide down. Now slide toggle changes the view depending upon the previous state of the div. So when I click on slide toggle now, it should slide up. When I click it again, it should slide down. Same thing will happen because we have used slide toggle method here. This is the method we are using to toggle slide. Now we are using fade in and fade out. So we can see the div appearing fading inside our web page when we use fade in method, and when we use fade out, we can see our div to go with a fade out effect. So we'll see fade out first. When I click on fade out button, the div disappears with a fade out effect. When I click on fade in, the div appears again with a fade in effect. So this is how effects in jQuery works. Thank you.